Dominicans, fellow voters, the Dominica Freedom Party is proud to be standing in this December 2009 general elections. I want to appeal to all Dominicans, all voters, to ensure that they make every vote count. We in the Dominica Freedom Party have stood firm with you as a party since 1968, a party that has been founded on sound principles, principles which put people before power, people before politics, and people before privilege and things. The Dominica Freedom Party is a party you can trust. It is a party that will bring you good governance. Without good governance in government, we are unable to provide sustainable development for our people, for all the young people on whose shoulders the future development of this country will lie. The Dominica Freedom Party, with its plans for development, will ensure that all Dominicans have a stake in the development of the country. We are going to address the major development issues. Issues concerning health, education, crime, tourism, agriculture, energy, and these are just among some of the many issues which will be reflected in our manifesto, which you will shortly be able to see. We are concerned about the developments that are taking place recently in our country. We cannot be proud of our country if we do not have sound, honest leadership, leadership which is accountable, leadership which is transparent, and leadership which will enable us to hold ourselves proud to be Dominicans. I appeal to all women voters. As a woman and as a successor to Dame Eugenia Charles, as leader of the Dominica Freedom Party, I encourage you to emulate the ideals which she stood for, the principles which she believed in. Without the Dominica Freedom Party, for 15 years in office, from 1980 to 1995, we would not have achieved the development we today have, developments which have created employment for all Dominicans. We just have to look around and see the kind of projects that the Dominica Freedom Party completed in office. Projects which today are ensuring that vendors, taxi drivers, tour operators, and people employed in the tourism sector particularly have been able to secure a livelihood from. When we look at agriculture, we see the demise of the banana industry. The Dominica Freedom Party will ensure that agriculture again becomes one of the dominant sectors of development in the country. We have to create employment for our young people. We have to ensure that the people we train have the quality education and the skills needed to respond to the needs of the job market. We have to continue to encourage Dominicans residing overseas to come back and make a contribution to the development of the country. But among all this, we have to remember that whatever we do is for love of country and not for love of self. I urge all Dominicans to come out on December 18th, stand with the Dominica Freedom Party, vote the party you can trust, put Dominica back in safe hands, because without honesty, good governance, integrity, transparency, and accountability in government, we will not be able to secure that sustainable future for us all. Thank you.